在这个疫情期间啊，我有比较多的时间可以来做一些个人的测验。So during this lockdown, I have more time to do some self-experimentation. 那这一次呢，我决定花两个星期的时间来比较我身体对低碳生酮跟比较高碳饮食的反应，特别是在单车训练的时候的反应差别是如何。So during this time, I'll be comparing my physiological response to two different types of diet, basically a ketogenic low-carb diet versus my physiological response to a higher carbohydrate diet. 那我会用不同的工具来测量我身体的反应。And I'll be using various tools to measure and compare my physiological response. 那这些工具包括我会测血糖跟血酮。So I'll be measuring my blood glucose and my blood ketone. 那也会用血氧机来看我的心跳跟血氧在不同强度训练的变化，在不同饮食之下是不是会有差距。And I'll also be measuring my blood oxygen levels using this oximeter to see whether my heart rate and blood oxygenation changes during training with the different diets.那当然我也会用那个气筒机来测量我的身体的变化。Of course, I will also be using the breath ketone devices to measure my ketone level differences. 那最后也会用这个连续型血糖仪来看我身体对不同强度的反应。So I will also using this continuous glucose,blood glucose monitor to measure my physiological changes according to different intensity of training. 那当然我会尝试不同的强度的训练来看看生理的变化。Of course, I will be training with different intensities to see how my body respond in different diets. 所以我会每一周的开始我都会先做一个我的 FTP 的测试。So every, at the beginning of the week, I will do an FTP test to establish a baseline. 所以一周我是会用生酮饮食然后做 FTP, 然后做一系列的训练跟测验。So one week, I will be under a ketogenic diet condition, and I will be doing all the training under a ketogenic diet.那另外一周我会增加我的碳水化合物的量，然后所有同样的 FTP, 然后跟之后的训练高强度的训练都是以补充碳水化合物的状态。So next week I will do the same thing. I will start with the FTP test and do the exact same training, but under a higher carbohydrate condition. 那这个训练会包括MAF 低心跳、低心率的这个基础缓和的训练。So this training will include a MAF low heart rate easy training. 那也会包括高强度的间歇训练 ，also include high intensity interval training. 那这会分成两类第一类是15秒、20秒很短暂的这种高强度的训练。So there will be two types of high intensity. First type is this 15 to 20 second maximum effort intensity training. 那第二类是比较长的，可能是10分钟在你的 FTP 左右或者是高一点点的这样子的一个强度的训练。So the second type of high intensity interval will be near or at or even above FTP for 10 minutes. 那我们就看看我最后的这个差别在什么地方 ？Then we'll take a look at the differences between the two. 那为了做这个训练，所以我就会带上这个连续型血糖仪。So for this training, I will be using this continuous glucose monitor. 那这个扎上之后，一个小时就可以开始读我的血糖。So after I put this on, an hour later, I will be able to measure my blood glucose. 那我目前的状态呢，其实不是生酮，我已经有好大概有一个月的时间，都有在补充碳水化合物，每天吃面包、吃水果等等的。So I'm currently not in a ketogenic state. For this past month, I've been eating a lot of carbohydrates, bread, fruits, honey. 所以那我，但是我一开始的测验会从生酮的状态，所以我会花一两天的时间让自己身体再进入酮态。So I'm going to start this experimentation with a ketogenic state. So that means I'm going to spend a couple days starting now to get myself into a ketogenic state. So that's it.那我就扎上了，那只要配对。So now I put this on, I just need to pair the device. 60分钟之后就可以开始启用。So 60 minutes later, then I can start taking measurements.